In this video, we're going to work a couple of problems involving dot products and angles. So our first problem says, let's suppose we've got a triangle with vertices at these three points, 2, negative 2, negative 1, 3, 1, and negative 3, and 7, negative 1, and 4. So there's a triangle, and our challenge is to figure out what are the angles of that triangle. So let's look at the picture. Okay, first thing we need to do is we need to figure out what are the vectors, displacement vectors, of going from one corner to another. So PQ, well, this vector, you get it by just subtracting the coordinates of P from the coordinates of Q. 3 minus 2 makes 1. 1 minus negative 2 makes 3. Negative 3 minus negative 1 makes negative 2. So the vector PQ is 1, 3, negative 2. PR, we subtract P from R, and we get that PR is 5, 1, negative 3. 7 minus 2, negative 1 minus negative 2, negative 4 minus negative 1. And finally, let's do QR. QR is 7 minus 3 makes 4, negative 1 minus 1 makes negative 2, negative 4 minus negative 3 makes negative 1. Okay, now that we've got our vectors, we can start to figure out angles between them. So what do we want? The first thing we're going to do is we're going to try to figure out the angle at P. And we know that if we take PR dotted into PQ, that has to give us the length of PR times the length of PQ times the cosine of the angle between them. So figuring out PR dot PQ is easy. This is 5 times 1 plus 1 times 3 plus negative 3 times negative 2. Is equal to the length of PR. Let's see, what the length of PR is the square root of 5 squared plus 1 squared plus negative 3 squared times the length of PQ. That's 1 squared plus 3 squared plus negative 2 squared times the cosine of alpha. So on the one hand, we got 14, and that's the square root of 25 plus 1 plus 9 makes 35. 1 plus 9 plus 4 makes 14 times the cosine of alpha. That means that the cosine of alpha is equal to 14 over square root of 14 times square root of 35, which is square root of 14 over the square root of 35, which is the square root of 2/5, because this is 2 times 7, this is 5 times 7. Okay, that's one of our angles. Next, we're going to try to figure out, so that gives us our cosine, and then if we want alpha, we have to take the inverse cosine of the square root of 2/5. Pull out a calculator, you get that angle. Next thing we're going to do is we're going to try to figure out the angle at Q. Call that beta. Now for that, we need the vectors coming out from Q. So instead of PQ, we want QP. And that's negative 1, negative 3, 2. QP is the vector going this way. PQ is the vector going this way. They both run between the two points. QP is coordinates of P minus coordinates of Q. PQ is the coordinates of Q minus the coordinates of P. So now we've got these two things, and we say, all right, we want to figure out the angle beta. So we need to take QP dotted into QR is the length of QP, times the length of QR times the cosine of. But QP dot QR, let's see, that's negative 1 times 4 plus negative 3 times negative 2 plus 2 times negative 1, and that's 0. So that's length of QP times the length of QR times the cosine of beta. And that means the cosine of beta is 0. You see, these vectors are orthogonal. Their dot product is 0, so they're orthogonal. And that means that beta is 90 degrees. Okay. We want the final angle gamma. We could play the same game, taking the inner product of RP and RQ. Or we can just subtract the result, you know, take pi minus alpha minus beta. Either way, we get that gamma is the inverse cosine of the square root of 1/5. So there's our answers. The alpha was the inverse cosine of 2/5. Beta was 90 degrees, so this is actually a right angle. And gamma is the inverse cosine of 1/5. The last thing to check is if this is a right angle, the sides should follow the Pythagorean theorem. Let's see if that works. The length of this side is the length of PQ. The length of PQ is the square root of 1 plus 9 plus 4. That's the square root of 14. The length of this side is the length of QR, and that's the square root of 16 plus 4 plus 1, which is the square root of 21. The length of PR is the square root of this dotted into itself, so that's 5 squared plus 1 plus 9. That's the square root of 35. Sure enough, this squared, which is 14, plus this squared, which is 21, makes this squared, which is 35. It satisfies the Pythagorean theorem. Everything works. Okay. For our second problem, we're going to look at the diagonals of a cube. So let's suppose we have a cube, and we look at the diagonal of one of its faces. And we look at the diagonal of another face, where these two diagonals meet at this point. And the question is, what is the angle between those two diagonals? To do that, we have to give coordinates to our points. So let's call this point the origin. And this will be the point 1, 0, 0. And this will be 1, 1, 0. Because we're going to take the x-axis in this direction, and the y-axis in this direction, and the z-axis is up. So this is the point 0, 0, 1. And this is the point 0, 1, 1. So if you call this vector, let's call it u, and call this vector v, we have that u is 1, 1, 0. I guess I should use angle brackets because it's a vector. And that v is 0, 1, 1. And the length of u is the square root of 2. The length of v is the square root of 2. And u dot v is 1 times 0 plus 1 times 1 plus 0 times 1 is 1. So 1 is equal to the square root of 2 times the square root of 2 times the cosine of theta. So the cosine of theta is 1/2, which means that theta is pi over 3, or 60 degrees.